Dr. Sharp, can you fill us in on what's going on?
Yes, thanks, Brenda. Good morning to everyone. We do have cases continuing to be reported from throughout the island. As you can see, there have been increases. And most recently, we are at just about 600 suspected cases coming in from throughout the island, of which we're seeing about 100 laboratory positive cases coming back per week. If we dig into this a little bit more, we do see that about 10% of all of our cases are pregnant women, especially amongst the 15 to 40-year-old age groups.
Of all parts of the United States, the hardest hit was Puerto Rico. And we anticipated that up to 1 in 4 adults would become infected in the first year, and that's exactly what happened.
The first reported case of Zika virus in Puerto Rico happened in December 2015. 1 year later, there were more than 34,000 people carrying the disease. This is the crisis that no one sees coming. Zika virus itself is a sign of a much greater threat. The only way an obscure disease explodes into a global epidemic is because of the delivery system. The mosquito.
Take Zika. In between 1947, when it was first discovered in East Africa and Uganda, and 2007, there were 14 documented human cases. And right now, we're seeing publications where it's being estimated that 2.5 billion people, you know, almost a third of the human population worldwide, might sooner or later become infected by this virus. Now, if that isn't a signal that the world is changing at a dramatic pace, then I don't know.
For all of our advances, our ingenuity, our technology, we are increasingly at risk to infectious disease. We've been fighting sickness for centuries, but today a disease can spread around the world much faster than we could ever have imagined.
We got malaria coming across from Africa. Then we got yellow fever coming across from Africa. And then we got dengue coming across. It took around 3 centuries for these 3 diseases to make it from Africa across the Atlantic Ocean to the Americas. In the last 16 years, 3 more have been added to that list. West Nile virus, chikungunya virus, and Zika. 16 years for 3 diseases, 300 years for the 3 diseases that preceded it.
The reason is simple. The network we have created for global travel.
In the 1960s, travel used to be something very special. And these days, getting on an aircraft is like getting on a bus. There's a sea of blood at 10 kilometer height now. And in that sea of blood, there's viruses, there's parasites. Anything that can cause disease is traveling around the world now at an incredible speed.
Every year, there's a few cases. It's called airport malaria. When Mozambique sent a lot of people back to Portugal, you had enough people who had the malaria parasite in their blood that you had a period, actually, where you had transmission back in Europe. And whenever you have people moving around, it can spread disease.
I could be infected with Zika. I show up to a different country. I walk off the plane. I feel fine. And then all of a sudden, a couple of days later, I get sick. And then a mosquito would bite me and then be able to then transmit that disease to somebody else.
Zika is named after the Zika forest in Uganda, where the virus was first identified in a population of monkeys in 1947. The first human cases migrated out of Africa and into Malaysia. It took 60 years for the first major outbreak in Micronesia, 2007. Then it swept through the Pacific Islands. It's believed Zika reached South America because of an international sporting event, the 2014 Canoeing World Championships in Rio. 4 competing countries had already documented cases of the Zika virus. Within weeks, hundreds of people were known to be infected. Brazilian soldiers began spreading insecticides in a war against mosquitoes. Thousands warned residents, shouting dengue, a familiar disease, as most people had never heard of Zika.
Urbanization around the world means that there's a lot more trash in cities that is not being cleaned. Trash that can form potential breeding sites, very close to large concentrations of humans. Lots of mosquitoes, all congested in an urban setting, which means that transmission of a virus can go very, very, very fast.
A single mosquito bite in Brazil set off a nightmare scenario. Zika results in a neurological condition known as microcephaly, an underdeveloped head and brain.
Eu tinha dias que eu tinha 25, 30 crianças atendendo assim. De repente, começamos a ver nos consultórios. O cérebro, ele é o computador central do corpo. Se ele está danificado, é igual ao seu computador quando está danificado. Você não consegue mais nada nele. Então, ele está com isso aqui fechado. Fontanela anterior está fechada. Precisa para o cérebro crescer que isso aqui abra.
Eu não pedi para meu filho vir doente, eu não pedi, ele não quis nascer, ele não pediu para nascer assim. Tá todo irritado. Meu filho vai depender de mim pro resto da vida dele.
Many people had sort of discounted Zika. You get a little fever-like illness with a, you know, with a rash and a headache and red eyes. And then all of a sudden we recognized in Brazil that Zika virus is essentially a guided missile for brain cells.